Assalamualaikum. This is the second part video tutorial of creating pillow inside 3ds Max. If you get to this video accidentally, please check out the first part before watching this one. Okay, now we're moving on to the simulation parameters. First, turn off both use sewing springs and show sewing springs options in here. If use sewing springs is on, you will see the gap between panel seams of the garment maker, which is not what we want. Next, make sure self-collision and solid collision are all turned on. The self-collision option will make cloth simulation calculate collision between the cloth itself. The solid collision will make our cloth collide with solid object, and in this case is our sofa. This option usually turned on by default and should always be turned on. If we look at the cloth modifier, we can see we have so many simulation buttons. Simulate local damped, and simulate. What are the differences? Okay, first, the simulate button in here is the main tool for simulating. This button will simulate the cloth and creating keyframes along the way. Notice if I click this button, it will start simulating for frame 0, 1, then 2, then 3, and so on until frame 100, which is specified in this parameter. One important value for this type of simulation is this subsample option in here. I set this to 3. This means that for every one frame, 3ds Max will calculate 3 subframes to refine the simulation. Higher value will cause the simulation takes more time, but create more stable and better result of the cloth behavior. After doing simulation, cloth modifier will display the amount of frames it already calculated. We can see the number displayed in here. And if we scrub the track bar, we can see the animation in the viewport. If we want to erase the animation, we can click this erase button, and now the keyframes generated before will be erased. The simulate local button will simulate the cloth without adding any keyframes. It will simulate it one frame and will not add up to this simulated number in here. Notice when we scrub the track bar, we don't see any animation happening. The last button is simulate local damped. This button will simulate locally like this one, but will reduce the gravity and any other physical force in the simulation. It's like moving the cloth inside water where everything moves slowly. Okay, now let's reset the state. You simulate local damped first. It will pull in the stitches first until all of the seams are closed. Then the pressure will start to kick in. Okay, now simulate. Stop the simulation and move back and forth to find the best position for the pillow that you like. I think I like this position. Now we're going to make several pillows by snapshot this current pillow condition as a new mesh. To make a snapshot of the current mesh condition, we can use Mesh Snapshot. Go to Tools menu, Snapshot. Then just click the OK button. Now we actually have two pillow objects, one that has cloth modifier attached to it and being simulated, and one that already a mesh object, but they are in the same exact position. Okay, now press reset state button again. Move this to another position. We can rotate this a bit. Now we're going to simulate and drop this again. But we want the previous pillow to collide with our simulated pillow. So go to Object Properties and add the new mesh pillow and set it to Collision Object. Again, this step is optional if you only want to collide the cloth with the previous pillow. Okay, now press Reset State button again. For the rest of the pillow, just repeat the process. Before we render the pillow, notice our pillow may not look smooth as the polygon count on folded areas are lacking. To overcome this, we may want to use subdivision modifier like Turbo Smooth. But Turbo Smooth is designed for quad base polygon, and our pillow model are triangle base. The best alternative is to use HSDS modifier. First, let's add HSDS modifier, go to polygon mode, and select only the part of the folded area. Then hit subdivide. Now we have more polygons on folded areas, making it look smoother. But now we have a problem of excessive polygon counts. We can, however, optimize this using optimize modifier. Go to modifier list and add optimize modifier. Notice the polygon count drops significantly, but the topology of the pillow preserves. I think 4 is too much, so I'm going to reduce this to 3. And now we have better details on our folded areas. Okay, now we have a very optimized mesh. Something to be aware though, optimized modifier will break your UV mapping. Okay, I repeat, it will break your UV mapping. You can, however, project the UV mapping from the original mesh, or you can also use multi-res modifier instead of optimized modifier, but that will be for another tutorial. Okay, so this optimized modifier step is not recommended if you are using texture on the pillow. If you are using only solid color or other procedural map such as fall off, noise, etc., then adding optimized modifier should be fine. Okay guys, that is all from me. I hope this tutorial is beneficial for you. I am making video tutorial about computer graphic every week inshallah. So please hit the subscribe button to follow up my future tutorials. And please do share and tweet my videos so more people can take benefit from it. Thank you for watching. Wassalamualaikum.